Hello and welcome to the Standards Tools training. My name is Brian Ambrosini and I'm here to introduce how to calculate refrigeration custom measures using the standard refrigeration tool that was developed. Our main learning objectives today are to show project developers, and that includes field engineers, implementers, trade allies, and anyone basically with an engineering background that's dealing with our custom program for refrigeration customers. The target audience, like I said, are engineers that develop refrigeration projects. And with that said, I'm going to switch it over to Melina, who's going to give you a little bit more direction on how to use the tool, what the inputs are, and go through a few examples. All right, take it away, Melina.
Thank you, Ryan. So basically, in the refrigeration tool, we have three types of equipment that we have developed. One is the refrigeration compressor, the evaporators, and the condensers. If you have attended or watched the HVAC tool, you will see that for each of the type of equipment, we had a different tab. In this case, they are all in one calculation tab that I will show you later. But those are the three types of equipment for which we have developed energy efficiency measures. There are seven measures that we have included in the calculator, and we did include different refrigerant types that you can choose depending on what the customer has at their facility. And so both the seven measures are RCX and also retrofit measures, and the refrigerant types are 5 of them. So just choose we found that those were the five most common refrigerant types, so just choose the one that the customer has. And just a quick introduction. So the tool has different tabs for customer information, one main tab for calculations, one main tab for compressor inputs, and a different tab for reporting. There are different cell types. The green cell type means that's a baseline operating condition cell. If it's blue, it means that it's a proposed input. And if it's yellow, it means that it can be two different things. Either you are enabling a measure, you want to see how much energy savings that measure can save, and you can also choose what kind of type of calculations you have. And we will have two different types of calculations. One of them is detailed, and that will require more information from the engineer, and the other one is simplified. That will require just some simpler inputs for projects that they are a little bit smaller, and also maybe for those types of projects for which we don't have a lot of information, or you just want to get a sense of how much the potential is for certain measures. The inputs will be what kind of equipment you have, the type of refrigerant, horsepower, efficiency, and we will show you later which ones those are. And the outputs, we will show you what the baseline energy usage is, what the energy usage is for the energy efficiency measures, also the savings, the payback, ROI, and also now the savings to investment ratio. And we will go over a couple of examples. The first example I'm going to focus on is this small refrigerated warehouse. And the key for this example is that I'm going to show you how to run a calculation with simplified inputs. And so I will show a couple of measures. In this case, we have one. The customer has this small warehouse that is really well built, and infiltration is small. And so PG&E is helping the customer increase the efficiency of their refrigeration system. This is a smaller system, and so the customer doesn't train their refrigeration system or equipment energy usage, but we do have some input or some information about how the system operates. And the PG&E engineer has found a couple of measures that might save some energy, like installing BFDs on the condenser fans and implementing fluorine head pressure. And the total cost for the measures is estimated at $20,000. In the second example, the key that we want to show here is how to run a calculation with more detailed inputs. In this case, the system is bigger. They have three compressors that have a 700-ton capacity in total, and they do have a lot of trend data related to that refrigeration system. So PG&E has gone out there and they are investigating potential savings for flooring head pressure, staging the compressors, and installing BFDs on the evaporators.